Uranus is not a very photogenic place. It looks more or less like a big blue ping pong ball. But we did see clouds in the atmosphere of Uranus, and they did tell us something. In fact, Uranus is a tipped over version of Jupiter and Saturn. The cloud patterns are more muted, but they have the same kind of banded structure that Jupiter and Saturn have. Now, what that says is that the spin of a planet is the all-important process or thing that organizes weather.
Uranus is a very peculiar planet in the sense it's tipped on its side right now with the south polar region headed pointed at the sun. We had expected that the magnetic field pole would also be up near the rotational axis, so the magnetic field would be tipped on its side. What we found was, to everyone's surprise, that the magnetic field, rather than being pointed at the sun, was tilted some 60 degrees from the rotation axis. Not only that, but the center of the magnetic field was displaced from the center of the planet by almost a third of the radius of the planet. Uranus's magnetic field is a bit stronger than that on Saturn. And it extends some 300,000 miles from the planet. The rotation period, that is the length of the day on Uranus, is measured by how rapidly the magnetic field is rotating, is about 17 and a quarter hours.
The Uranian rings are inherently dark. In fact, they are no brighter than coal dust. So imagine trying to take an image of coal dust at twilight, but it's even worse than that. So we had to worry about the necessity of using long exposures and the fact that the spacecraft scan platform is not a stable platform and always moves someone. Best image that we got, in fact, of the Uranian ring system, we had to use image motion compensation. What we saw in that image is a sheet of dust that extends throughout the Uranian ring system, and this sheet of dust is punctuated by features, many of them. There are more features in that picture than there are rings seen from inbound. So we have 9 narrow rings seen in the inbound images, and one newly discovered one, the Lambda ring.
The moons of Uranus revealed a fascinating variety of terrain. The moon Titania has a surface pitted with many impact craters. Also visible is a large fault valley covered with frost. The surface of Ariel, another moon, was also found to have long faults and valleys. These faults are thought to have been caused by expansion of the moon's crust. Voyager 2 passed closer to the moon Miranda than to any other body it had encountered, and so was able to produce spectacular high-resolution images of this strange moon. There are many craters and several grooved areas, including an unusual V-shaped region named the Chevron. In this view of Miranda, huge ice cliffs are visible at the bottom, and there are many impact craters.
It is a very exotic and complicated place. Most of the regions that we viewed are heavily cratered, old, rolling, ancient terrains. But embedded in these are very unusual circular patches, almost like racetracks, of grooved terrains that run around in circular bands, surrounding very complicated crisscrossing structures in the interiors.